The question, why did the skeleton go to the party alone? He had no body to go with him. The skeleton can be divided into two main sections, the axial and appendicular. Combined, our body has 206 bones. The axial skeleton is our core skeleton, and it protects organs of the body and is composed of 80 bones. The appendicular skeleton contains 126 bones. It is your appendages, arms and legs, as well as the hip and shoulder girdles. Bones are classified according to shape. Long bones, short bones, flat bones, and irregular bones. Up first, long bones. They are longer than they are wide. They are found in your arms and legs. Examples include the ulna, radius, femur, tibia, and fibula. The femur is the longest and strongest bone in your body. Short bones are fairly equal sized in width and length, similar to a cube. They're found mostly in your wrists and ankles. For example, your foot consists of 26 bones. Flat bones are thinner bones that can be either flat or curved. Examples include your ribs, scapula, hip, and breastbone. Irregular bones are odd-shaped bones needed to connect other bones. They provide protection, for example, the nerves of the spinal cord. Examples include the vertebrae. A couple functions of the skeletal system. It provides support, facilitates movement, protects internal organs, helps produce blood cells, and stores minerals and fat. Support. Just as the steel beams of a building provide a scaffold to support its weight, the bones and cartilage of your skeleton system compose the scaffold that supports the rest of your body. Movement. Bones facilitate movement by serving as points of attachment for your muscles. Protect internal organs. Bones also protect internal organs from injuries by covering or surrounding them. For example, your ribs protect your lungs and heart. Produce blood cells. The softer connective tissue that fills the interior of the bone is referred to as bone marrow. Red marrow is where the production of blood cells take place. Red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets are all produced in this red marrow. And stores minerals and fats. On a metabolic level, bone tissue performs several critical functions. For one, the bone matrix acts as a reservoir for a number of minerals important to the functioning of the body, especially calcium. These minerals incorporated into the bone tissue can be released back into the bloodstream to maintain levels needed to support physiological processes. Bone matrix. Here's what it looks like. And why was the skeleton not allowed to play church music? Because he had no organs. Let's get back to these original questions. The rib cage would be part of the axial skeleton. And also, you know, the skeleton system provides several functions, including protection, support, movement, produces blood cells, and stores minerals and fats. Organized notes and handouts are available. Please check out the comments. And thanks for watching. And MooMooMath uploads a new math and science video every day. Please subscribe.